Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. In today's video, I wanted to dive into some more functional planning tips while I set up my week in my hourly planner. If you've never seen this planner before, this is one that I created. I do sell it in my Etsy shop. If you're interested, you can check out the description box below. I'm also going to be using all of the functional stickers that I sent out in my sticker kit this month. If you don't know, I have Tom Squad, which is my Patreon membership group. It's $10 a month and you get 6 sheets of stickers from me every single month. If you're interested, that will also be in the description box. So now let's jump into the functional planning tips. My very first tip is something that I just started doing recently, maybe in the last 2 to 3 weeks in my planner, and that is to write in all of my plans first, and then I will add stickers. Now, this tip isn't for everyone. This is for us really functional planning girls that need a lot of space to write things in on your planner. So I used to try and decorate first and add all of these stickers, but then a lot of time I wouldn't have enough space to write in everything that I needed to write in my planner. So what I decided to start doing instead is to write in all of my planners first and then use small functional stickers to decorate afterwards. It has really made a major difference because now I'm able to use my planner the way that I have designed it to use it, and that's to actually get things done. My second tip is specifically for us hourly planner girls, and that is to draw your arrow next to your plans, either to the right of your plans or to the left of your plans, instead of directly down the middle. So in the past, I would draw my arrows directly down the middle of my plans to mark off how much time I needed for that specific thing. The problem with that was if I had anything else coming up or I needed to add in additional information regarding those specific plans, I never had enough space. So what I started doing instead is drawing my arrows to the left or to the right of my plans. More than likely, mine are usually to the left. And then that way I have way more space and I can still jot down other things that I may need to do during that exact same time. My third tip is to use stickers in order to signal your brain and let yourself know when you have something that you have to do and you don't have the space to write. For instance, right directly after our team meeting, I need to go and get groceries. It's going to take us about an hour to go and pick up the groceries. And instead of me writing that in, I will use a little grocery bag to let myself know that that's something that I need to do at this specific time. This is a way to not let my planner get too crowded where I just have to write in every single thing that I have to do. A lot of times I will use functional stickers in order to let myself know that I need to pick up groceries or post to Instagram or post a YouTube video. And instead of writing it out completely, I'll add a sticker and it still lets me know that that's what I'm supposed to be doing at that specific time. My fourth tip is something that I've talked about before, but since I'm doing it right now, I just wanted to mention it again. And that is to use your sidebar to keep track of your goals that you have for the current week and your plans for next week. I love to use my sidebar in order to jot down all of the different things that's coming up in my next week so that I can kind of prepare my mind or prepare for whatever I may need to do. And I can use this sidebar when I am planning that very next week. It is super helpful to have this little section to jot down different things that's coming up. My next tip is to have a place where you can jot down the weather. So I had gotten away from this for a couple of weeks, but I quickly came back to it when I was stuck outside without an umbrella, and that is to add my weather to my top. So I will usually use some little weather stickers to just kind of let myself know if it's raining or sunny so that I can be prepared. Also, as you are planning your day and you are looking at everything that you want to do, you want to make sure that your days are well-rounded. So I used to have this issue where I would put so many things that I wanted to do that were business-related in my planner, and I would kind of forget about everything else until my house was a complete mess and everything was all over the place. So nowadays, I try and make sure that my planner is well-rounded, so I will make sure I have something from my business, from home, from my family, projects that I'm working on, goals that I may have. That way, I am not just super focused in on my business things, but I also am making sure that I am staying in contact, in touch with my family and my home. My next tip is to make sure that you use stickers that have white space and room to write. So as you can see, I've added my colorful boxes at the very bottom of my planner, and this is where I'm going to keep track of what we're eating for dinner. Now, I do have a dedicated planner in which I will jot down everything that I have eaten for my breakfast, lunch, and dinner. That's my personal planner. But in this one, I do like to keep track of dinner because this is my catch-all, so it has a little bit of everything. It's kind of like my well-rounded life is to make sure I'm staying on top of all aspects. So that's what I'm going to keep track here. And I love using colorful boxes because it's a way to draw your attention and highlight different areas of your life that you may want to pay attention to. Those colorful boxes will automatically draw your eyes there. My next tip is to make sure that you use insert sheets and notebook paper in order to keep all of your reference information. So I like to keep my planning routine and any other additional things that I need to do. It might be meeting notes, it might be just things that are from other sections or projects that I need to complete, on an insert sheet and add it into my planner. This makes it so much easier for me to stay on top of different things, and I don't have to keep flipping back from planner to planner if I just easily jot it down on this particular insert sheet and I have one for every single week. So I'm able to reference each one of these insert sheets for my planning routine and any to-dos that I might have throughout the course of the week. And then at the end of the week, I can take this to-do list and actually go back to the planner and fully write out all of the different things that were completed. So my catch-all is the main one that I am in throughout the course of the day. And then if I need more details, I will usually flip to another planner. And it helps me stay kind of all together. I don't have to go back and forth through the planners, but it's there if I need it. So guys, those are all of the functional planning tips that I have for you today. If you have any additional functional planning tips, make sure that you leave them in the comments below. I love to hear from you guys. I hope that you have enjoyed watching me plan everything for this week. My plans are pretty much the exact same every single week. I will just kind of do this exact same system, but I hadn't shown it in a while. So that's why we're doing this video and I wanted to share it with you. I hope you guys have a good one, and I will see you in my next video, which will be Monday. Until then, keep organizing your life so that you can achieve your dreams. Bye, guys.